two things. One's being respectful, and two is having fun. We've always managed to do that here at Catholic College. I do ask you to think about the people who prepare the auditorium, and so the people who will have to clean it up. So we're trying to manage streamers and things like that. So there's no need for you as an audience to pick them up and to accelerate and increase the amount of spread of the rubbish. So I do ask you to be respectful. So we're about to hand over to Dave Sider, our principal, and welcome our Year 12, another one of our fantastic assemblies.
Good afternoon, everyone. Especially, I would like to welcome the parents and the family members of our graduates who have taken the time to be with us for this assembly. This is probably one of the highlights of the year. One of the things that we do very well is have good relationships between all of us here at Catholic College. And one of the things that we want to make sure that we do is congratulate, celebrate with, and farewell appropriately our Year 12s. And that's why on their last day, Catholic College has them at school, because this day is significant. It's significant for you 11s all the way to 7 that you see how we farewell the Year 12s. Because this is part of our tradition. The tradition at Catholic College is something that is not etched in stone. It's dynamic. That means it's ongoing. And so, in your name, and in the name of the parents and the families and friends of our graduates, we welcome them here today. And so, let's enjoy the class of 2013.
You've done fine subject after fine subject, and now you've hit that high enter. And now your life's about to begin because
you Thank you. cemetery. Cow goes in, frog goes crow, and the elephant goes toot. Doesn't quack, the fish go blow, and the sea goes ow, ow, ow. But there's a sound that no one knows. What does the fox say?
Begins on my very first ever day of teaching in 2010, but my first class was a replacement period in Inala. I really had no idea what to expect, so I took down a storybook to calm down the crazy year nines. I distinctly remember walking into a noisy classroom and a very perky little Chloe Kankamath saying, "Excuse me, miss, how old are you?" That was my introduction to teaching. Since then, I've taught them every year, and I've grown to appreciate their warmth, humour, and their interest in those around them. I'd like to share with you now some of my own and other staff memories, and also some of the students' memories of the last 6 years and what their time here has meant to them. A lot of their memories seem to involve violence or physical harm, so I'm not sure what that says about them. This group, hard to imagine, started at Catholic College as little year sevens in 2008. They had their classes in E Block, and Hayden Lyon remembers Sue Lingham letting Andy, Bert, Cynthia, Sam, Patty and Jez wrestle in the classroom at lunchtime. Summer dropped Ash Lehman and broke her arm. And Zach Eisentrout thought laptops were touch screens and broke the screen. In year eight, Sam Gowring accidentally punched Alex Lincoln in the face. Ellie Hudson broke her arm at girls' footy. Ellie Vanderven played face plants in the tennis courts. Pat got backhanded in the library by George. Bernie ran into a door at ski camp. Minnie was attacked by clubbers. And Nell sent Nikki home in a wheelchair after lunchtime rugby. In year nine, this was the first group at Nanala, and Sandy remembers team teaching Bok Ed there and loving it. Stacey Hocken, sorry to anyone else that's had it, says it was her best year nine PE class ever. They went to Tassie and on outdoor trips. And of course, there were more accidents in year nine. Rothy broke her toe. Josh Smith fell into a hole digging weed with Teddy Tindall. Minnie stepped on a shovel that hit him in the face. And Deanie fell down a hill and threw up on the plane to Tassie. In year 10, there was the trip to Melbourne, and many remember the scavenger hunt, getting very lost and going to Luna Park. I was lucky enough to teach two classes of outdoor ed in year 10, and our trips were a lot of fun. On our canoe trip, the catch cry became, "Put your shoes on, Franny." Tom set fire to his Trangia. We got caught in a lightning storm and had to make camp in a cow paddock. Jacko nearly cut his finger off with a tin of spaghetti. And Corey did the Morgan Freeman at every single trip. I'm sure many of you remember Natsumi, our Japanese exchange student. She was so excited to experience the real Aussie bush and so excited to make it. And she wouldn't have done it without all of you. I was so impressed by your support and encouragement of her and of each other. And I feel like it was on these camps that I really got to know a lot of you outside of the classroom. There were more memories made back at school in year 10. Many people remember when Pat Quinlevin accidentally said his hero was Dennis Ferguson instead of Fred Hollows. Hutchie was sent to the LCL by Miss Labrum in English and bawled his eyes out because he was too scared to see Mr. Lauren Lauren. When Andy Blackman offered and was taken up on the offer to get kicked in the balls for $1.40 so that he could buy himself a sausage roll. Then in 2012, they were into their VCE. There was a midweek break at Baker Cake Group, whose finest memory was when Sharon McAvoy, otherwise known as Shazmack, baked a cake for them. Lots of memories were made in the Walsh Wing with Raymar students remembering the pizzas catching fire on Catholic College Day and others remembering hospitality with the Walsh gang. Caitlin broke her finger attempting to do 1,000 years of death to Jess. Lots of boys remember intense downhill championships. And in English language, we spent most of the year laughing at Amy LaFoe. Including John being able to convince her that Yakandanda had its own currency. year level in the Mercy Centre, and Carmel remembers the excitement level when they first got in there, as well as the amusement of watching Mr. Cowan teaching maths to a very large flat screen TV. Although they are in fact in Year 12, it's fair to say that there's often been more of a focus on the social side of things for this group. Their memories are focused on things like Catholic College Day, dressing up, and beating the teachers in a soccer match. Although, I guess with 180 to 20, you might question the validity of the win. Burrell particularly remembers when I dropped him after he'd been trash talking me. No, Burrell, you didn't fall over, I pushed you. I vividly remember Basti Day, where a whole group made t-shirts, badges, and posters with Sebastian's face on them, and all came to school wearing them on casual clothes day. Bast had absolutely no idea what was going on. In Year 12, I will fondly remember all of the time spent in class, the famous Sean Darmody-Steph Gill academic rivalry, our whole history class sneaking outside and hiding while Cohen went to the toilet, and trying not to get people not to eat in the booths in the conference rooms. Of course, Year 12 wouldn't be the same without Lindley, aka Nemo. His language class will remember Lindley trying to push play for a PowerPoint on the laptop screen with his finger. And all those memorable Lindley quotes like, sweet FA, context, 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 no, 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 and of course, girls shouldn't play football. While I'm talking about Year 12, I'd like to mention Jared, Ali, Sam, Anna, Hayley, Holty and Vinny. It's been an absolute pleasure to work with this group, and as the Year 12 leadership team, they have put countless hours into meetings, planning, surveying their peers, organising, making videos, and being fantastic leaders and role models. For not just the Year 12s, but for the whole school. They are great representatives of your year level, and you should be very proud of yourselves for voting in such fantastic student leaders. The whole year level should also be commended on how they've come together to plan and coordinate this group act. It is not easy to get 180 people dancing the same thing at the same time, but they have worked together with enthusiasm over the last few weeks, and I don't think I'll ever see a fox again without thinking of them. This group has given a lot of themselves to staff. Marie has been so impressed with the amount of help that Year 12s have given in the canteen. And Rama was pretty surprised when, at its footy grand final, he ran out of the rooms to see about 20 Year 12s in matching t-shirts and wearing masks of his face, Rama's armour. I think this highlights how this group takes a personal interest in their teachers and are able to develop relationships that aren't just restricted to the classroom. I want to thank this group of students for all they have brought to CCW over the last 6 years. They are a genuinely kind group, and wherever they are, there are laughter and smiles. I know that personally they have given so much to me, and although I often get frustrated with their work or lack of work, I've enjoyed all the time I have spent with them, and I never get through a class without having a good laugh, and I know a lot of teachers feel the same way about this group. The relationships and the memories that we've formed will stay with me forever. Although they still have exams and will probably be hanging around for a while yet, this is their final day as Year 12 students, and they now leave to go on to new places, new people, and new experiences. They have embraced life at the school, and now they take their gifts into the world to share them more widely, and we are all so excited for them. As they leave CCW, whether that be to move away for tertiary education or work, to travel, or to stay in the Northeast, they go with the well wishes, the love, and the blessings of all the staff here at Catholic College. I'd like to finish with the words of my favourite poet, Dr. Seuss. I've read Oh, the Places You'll Go to all of my Year 12 classes this week, And for me, it perfectly captured the stage that you're all at now, about to head off. I don't have the time to read it all, unfortunately, but this little excerpt pretty much sums it up. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who'll decide where to go. And will you succeed? Yes, you will indeed. 98 3/4% guarantee. Kid, you'll move mountains. So be the name Buxton, or Bixby, or Bray, or Mordecai Alley, Van Allen O'Shea. You're off to great places. You're off and away. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. Thank you and good luck. Nerdy looking people. Hopefully Jackie's nose has stopped bleeding and they can come up and tell you a bit about what we're going to see today.
No, I'm fine.
I'm
Hey, I heard you had a girlfriend.
Yeah, I do!
How did you factor in the determinants to get the positive result?
I charmed her.
How?
Well, I went up to her and I asked, are you a bright angel? Because you are looking bright.
Oh my God. Next up, we have Hachi and Em, and they're doing Summer Loving.
Algebra. Yo, Vanilla, kick it one time, boy.
Thank you.
Jackson Green with his Mean Girls video.
Thank you.
Yes, we have the same story.
That old face thing, Bubba Bit.
Get comfortable, 'cause I
church maybe, and I'm feeling captive. Wow. You didn't tell me that was happening. In a short bit of time, so I'll just quickly get through this. Good afternoon, staff, students, and distinguished guests. You'll have to please excuse me, I only occasionally dress like this, so it's unfortunate to meet me on one of those days. Mind you, all credit to Jackie Looney and Kerry Holt, who have dressed me fabulously today. Now, when I started writing this the other day, I didn't know what I wanted to say to you, until a song came to me, and it pretty much summed it all up. Goodbye, my lovers. Goodbye, my friends. You have been the one. You have been the one for me. And then I started thinking about my community of Hollows and the opportunities they've given me. I'm so Hollows, baby. I'm so Hollows. Thank you. Although this is the end, I'd like to take you back to the beginning. I was a high-pitched, red-headed mop of a kid who was nervous about entering high school. Since that day, much growth and change has occurred to me. I'm not talking about a slightly deeper voice or a groovy, versatile hairstyle that can flick both ways. I'm talking about the development of self that has occurred because of our great school. And not our buildings and our facilities, though they are phenomenal, but the people who make up our community. The welcoming nature of the students, the dedicated and passionate teachers that just want to see us do well, and the unconditional support of parents and families. And on that, to my parents, and to all parents and loved ones of Year 12s here today, I thank you. I really do. But it's hard work. 13 years of schooling is no easy ride, and anyone would be foolish to think so. It's a rollercoaster filled with ups and downs, and it's because of you that we have made it. So, thank you. That we made it, but in year level two. Through our journey, we have transformed from a year level team, unique people, to a unique year level, where cowlicks are considered sexy, free periods means you get first dibs on the toasters and microwaves, where happiness can come from a pass or an A plus, and trial exams are seen as a means to see where we're at without studying. A year level where redheads aren't a minority, and when nerds are, and when the smartest kids are not seen as nerds, but rather as, say, the rugby or bringing football. Where kindness is giving lifts to the mirror at lunch, and embarrassing someone comes in the form of changing their name for all to hear. We are a year level who have become unified for the goodness of giving and the helping hand in times of need, as well as always congratulating our pals in times of success. I've been absolutely privileged to be one of your captains for our final year here. But I couldn't have had such an amazing year without an incredible team to work with it, especially with the likes of Hutchie, Stefani, Crazy Kids, and Jill Burdack running around. I'd like to start with my fellow Capitano Bell. Your willingness to do the things you've done for this school is remarkable, and all hard work has been done with a smile. I've struggled with the ability to keep organised and on top of what meetings we had and when, and I admire you so much because not only have you managed all this for yourself, but make sure I know what's going on too, so thanks heaps for that. You're a funny, funny gal, Al, and I'm sure you'll lead an extraordinary life. I was going to call Vin, Hales, Chris, Sam, and Holt and Hannah onto the stage. However, we're running out of time, so I just want to say these six people deserve just as much credit as we. And, of course, we've spent so much time with one another, there have been some conflicting opinions. However, they have been nothing compared to the good times galore we've shared. I've been so fortunate that you're such a fabulous bunch, not just Ellen and I thank you, but everyone here for being such jazzy community leaders. And to the mother of our little family, so to speak, Tess, the time and love you put into this job is beyond incredible, and has really been the engine for motivating us this year. Thank you so much for everything, and I hope that you, along with all the other teachers, come out and celebrate with us well into the night. This is the culture is set by the principal, and Dave Sider leaves us this year. I'd like to thank him, the deputies Richard Bentz, Tony Gould, Sarah Carter, and the leadership team. The well-being staff, your open doors and willingness to always listen is something that everyone admires, so thank you for that. Sandy McCoy, beautiful soul, you know how spectacular this is. you're worried about what you're going to do in the future. Don't you worry, guys. Sandy's got a plan for you. The other day, I decided to take home all the books in my locker. I began getting quite emotional, sentimental rather. Not because of the fact that I was taking things from school, but because I was never coming back to place my lock on a new locker. I've had this lock since the beginning of my days here, and I've really become attached to the rusty little fella. I think we've all been late to class once or twice because apparently our lock wouldn't open. And it was in this moment that it hit me. School is like a lock. We have so many opportunities before us, different subjects, different friend groups, and different learning styles. We are constantly trying to become the best we can be, the best combination of ourselves, if you will. Until we reach this moment right now, where we are unlocked into the rest of the world, where adventures lay before us that will undoubtedly be spectacular. Our Year 12 group is sending the message to you that we are ready and excited about leaving this school, and we are. However, the realisation that today is our last day here is quite daunting. The safety and comfort that this school brings to us is enormous, and I have no doubt there will be a few tears as we walk out the school gate today. And so, to the extremely and astoundingly gorgeous year level that sits before me, thank you. Thank you for the support, good times, and above all, friendships that I've been blessed with over the years. With the room of this time shared that you will last a lifetime, I sincerely wish you all the best with your future endeavours, and I'm sure you will do wonderful in whatever it is that you choose. I'd like to leave you with a quote from a woman who I have the utmost respect for, a woman who is at the heart of this school, Louise Simons. She told me sometime last week that once a student at Catholic College, always a student at Catholic College. And I think that this quote is so relevant for not only we who are departing, but for the entirety of this school. I've met many people in my life, yet never have I met anyone who speaks about their school in the same light that we here talk about ours. This essence of community spirit is a real thing at our college. And what gives me confidence about leaving is knowing that at any moment, if we stumble in the outer world, we will always, always have this wonderful school greeting us with open arms if we ask for guidance. So, from the bottom of my heart, I thank each and every one of you dearly for what has been and what will continue to be.
Jared took all my time, I'm going to have to rush through this one, so thank you for that, Jared. Alright, so as you mentioned through your Catholic college journey, you are always made aware that at some point it will come to an end. Each year you see another graduating class enter Year 12 and finish, sitting exactly where we are now. But as an individual, your final day of your high school life always seems like a distant point. It lingers in the back of your mind, especially as you enter into senior school. But it continues to hold an out-of-field reach until you finally reach it. The point where you must exit the comforts of this loving community and begin the next chapter of your life. If we were a Harry Potter book, we would only be finishing the first two chapters of the first book. Entering Hogwarts, building our new world. But what an amazing few chapters we, as a year level, have already experienced here at Catholic College. The diverse and extremely talented community here has enabled us as students to be involved in the endless opportunities the college presents to us. New adventures and memories have been created from these opportunities. To be in Galen in girls' footy in Year 8 after a minute to go goal from Gemma Grimmett. Or being taught to reel fish in crocodile-infested water on the Indigenous Bathurst Island. All opportunities have paved the way to who we've become as individual people. And we thank the school for allowing us to immerse ourselves in these valuable moments, as they will continue to help us through our own challenges that we are faced with outside of school. We as a group have always been adaptable to change throughout the college. A major one being the transition of our home bases in houses becoming learner communities. When we first ventured into Year 9, a transition that we have enjoyed seeing develop our real sense of belonging here at the college and to further our community base as a whole school. This has allowed us to create lasting relationships with our learning mentors and learning community leaders, which majority of us Year 12s wouldn't have been able to reach this ending point without their constant support and guidance. And this includes all staff that have been part of our journey, especially those this year that have pushed us Year 12s to limits we ourselves thought we could not achieve. Your continual understanding and faith in us will help us through the hard road that lies ahead with exams and such. A change that we adapted to quite quickly was the transition to our new study facility, the Mercy Centre. After a bit of a delay with its opening, our first day in the new centre truly set in that we were officially Year 12s. The endless amount of whiteboards, weird chairs, and oddly shaped couches all made up a great place for us to study and sleep. But one of the main parts that made the Mercy Centre so special was the people that we saw every day when we walked in working hard for us. Anne Ryan, Lisa, and the beautiful Carmen. Thank you all for everything you have done for us. We appreciate and value all your support and the stationery that you always let us borrow. And of course, the amazing woman in the little office tucked in the corner. Sandy strives to support each and every student, and that is why she gains so much respect from us. So thank you, Sandy. Being a part of the student leadership team has been an absolute honour and a privilege that I have enjoyed thoroughly. Jared and I both agree this year's student leadership has definitely not been influenced by just the two of us, as of course there is no I's in team. So to our fellow community leaders, Anna, Vinny, Hayley, Sam, Preston, and Colty, I would like to say a massive thank you for your admirable efforts this year. All your work and your amazing willingness has really been the backbone of the success of this year. And to the most wonderful partner in crime, Jared Tormey, thank you for being you, because you are great. It has been a truly great experience working with this year. Your knowledgeable approach and commitment to this role is awe-inspiring, and there is never a dull moment in your presence, and I mean never. Lastly, to my beautiful year level. We have been through a lot. The dramas of year 8, the welcoming of the frame kids in year 9, and the introduction to exams and the notion of stress in years 10 and 11. This year we have all grown a lot closer with the Mercy Centre and the constant stress of SACs bringing us all together. And this is a time for celebration for all that hard work we have put in throughout the year. And even though our job isn't quite complete yet, you should all be commended on your superb efforts that you have produced this year. Year 12 was never meant to be easy, especially when Lindley Horrocks is teaching you. But here we are. We made it. We are the seeds that have begun to nourish the school, and as we leave this campus for the last time as students, we shall continue to grow and nourish our own chapters in our lives. So thank you.